The scientific findings we have found recently, Hindu saints had found ages ago, thousands of years before. Why do we learn about it here, not only here, but in India as well, and not about the Hindu saints?
Our history doesn't come from us. It is imposed on us. We have never been given dignity at all. A lot of things that we already possess has never been acknowledged. For example, do you think today when I talk about pluralism on BBC or wherever, they're going to say, oh yes, they've run away from me. They cannot dignify, they cannot give us the credit that we deserve. This is nothing new. In fact, for thousands of years, you know, I mean, this nation, very ancient civilization, the first university in the world came in India. We'll discover a lot of things. Astronomy, medicine, we have developed tremendous things, but never ever have we been credited. And can I tell you who's the biggest culprit? And I like to say this on air, and this goes to BBC. Show me one documentary by BBC which shows India or Hinduism in a good light. Show me one. They can't. They'll always show it is a very weird religion. You know, some naked fakis dancing and smoking ganja. Yes, Hinduism. Well, damn it, you know, we talk about pluralism, spiritual humanism, you don't even, you haven't heard those words. And we give you this highest material and you're kind of focusing on these naked sadhus. There's much more to us than naked sadhus. So they have never dignified us. The history has been written by the West. And then, in fact, the best way they can demolish, if you like, a dignity or a character of an identity of a nation is to crack its backbone by, in a way, superimposing their own vision that this is what you are. You are just kind of creepy crawlies, nobody. So we have lost our own self-confidence. Is it necessary for youngsters like this to say, no, we know what we are all about. We already know. We are much ahead of you than you ever imagined. So the most dynamic ideas we possess, which the modern Western world requires so desperately, like religious pluralism or spiritual humanism, they can't acknowledge. Do you know why they can't acknowledge? If they acknowledge any of these two, like arrows we are firing at the West, if they acknowledge it, Abrahamic traditions will crash. They'll crash overnight because their theology is gone in two ticks. So they just can't acknowledge it because it will demolish their own theology. In two ticks, it will demolish it because nobody in heaven now. You can't go to heaven. You're going to be coming back here and again, again and again. Sort yourself out here, not in the heaven. The whole theology of going to heaven is gone. The whole, all three Abrahamic tradition will crash. That is why they will not allow it. But I'm struggling. But I'll get around using social media.